Sure, Bafetu, welcome back again to another banging episode of Groove Cartel. You know, we bring you nothing but the hottest DJs, producers. Today we've got Detroit native, Mr. Elton Miller. I'm handing over to him and he'll take it from here. Go ahead, sir.
Ooh. my heart. Ooh. When I'm with you, it's like my day, but then the sun sets whenever you walk away, and the night falls whenever we're apart. Feel like I was sleeping till I met. Dreaming.
divinity of Africa, in the rising of Africa by Mother Africa, as she births to her children and feeds her children the seed of the soil, and the soil comes planted. And the rising is uprising and expanding to the spirit and the soul of the uprising. One unity, one rebirth.
Thank you. I'm feeling you, girl.
Fetu, you know, killer set by Mr. Elton Miller.
Thank you, sir.
How are you?
I'm good, man. It's good to be here in Alex.
Thank you.
With
thank
the
you
gents.
So much. Had a good time, man.
I had a good time, man. Good set. I got a chance to play some tunes and play some new stuff and listen to some stuff. And that's the beauty of music. This is what we do on the weekends, right?
Yeah. Taking it easy.
Taking it easy with the cuts, man.
Yeah.
Nice and easy.
Chill. Yeah. Just give us a little bit of background about who you are. You know, your music career kind of started in the Early 80s? Do we go
Back? No, we go farther than that.
Really?
Actually. My name is Alton Miller. For those who don't know, I hail from Detroit, born in Chicago. I can claim both.
Detroit what?
The tale of two cities.
Yeah,
the birthplace of house and techno.
Nice.
Chicago house, Detroit techno.
Yeah.
My career is off to an early start, man. We're talking elementary school. My first experience or formal training or education, as people would say, or as you could say, was through the radio.
Okay.
Radio. I just had a very deep discussion about this the other day, about what with a friend back in the States. Someone I grew up with, about what we used to listen to.
Yeah, yeah.
And how there was AM, which was like a mono frequency, FM.
Yeah.
Black people didn't know about FM until the stations that we used to listen to on the AM frequency switched over to FM.
Wow.
So I used to listen to a lot of radio, man.
Yeah.
A lot of radio. I mean, obviously out of Detroit, coming from Detroit, there was the Motown thing happening in the 70s. You know, there was an influx of music coming from all sorts, because in all different genres, because we're talking post-civil rights movements. In the 70s, black people were given things that we had been fighting for a long time. So in the 70s, we were able to sort of say, let our head down, relax a bit. In essence.
Yeah. So you're kind of at the forefront of that.
Yeah, man. So everything was danceable. People wanted to dance and they wanted to be happy and they wanted to relax after all those struggles.
Yeah.
Music, specifically R&B and soul, had a danceable beat. Had more, in the 70s, it had more of a 4-4 backbeat.
Yeah.
Pre-disco. Disco in the fact that disco is a label.
Okay. I get. Yeah.
R&B, soul, disco comes from that.
Yeah.
That danceable, very funky side of R&B and soul. Mm. That's the beginning of my education. And then I've been at it since. Yeah.
Tell us about your experience in South Africa. What are your thoughts? In fact, your first impression when you got here? What did you think, and what do you think?
I was told by a dear friend, Vic Lavender, we used to talk about coming to South Africa because he started coming here maybe a year or so before I did.
Yeah.
And I would talk to him about his experiences. And the main thing that he would mention was the radio.
Yeah.
The radio. Yeah. Unlike the States, you know, radio here is, you play everything, and with house being as strong as hip-hop or R&B.
Yeah, yeah.
So he told me about, you know, we would talk about that because it was always about the music.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then we would talk about the landscape and everything and the culture and blah, blah, blah. So, you know, I remember those talks, and I got here, my first time here was December 2011, right at the beginning of festive season. I'm still in love with South Africa.
Thank you.
And I hate using the word South Africa because it's Africa.
Yeah,
you know, I know we have to define the region. I'm at the original Black Bottom.
Yeah.
You know, here.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I enjoy it, man. Every aspect, the food, culture, the people, the fact that it's Africa. You know, I've been fortunate enough to see the world based on what I do, my passion.
Yeah.
Blah, 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 blah. So yeah.
No, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So the viewers at home, they'd like to follow you. How do they get
DJ Alton Miller on Instagram, Facebook is the same. DJ Alton Miller, blah, 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 blah,
yeah, blah,
blah,
blah, blah, blah, blah, blah.
You can find me.
You will be found.
I will be found.
Thank you very much, sir. Dope set.
Thank you.
Dope chat.
Okay.
Be well. Hope you to see you too. Soon.
For sure.
I will.
Thanks to the brothers.
I will.
Heckle and Jekyll.
Yeah. Thank you very much for tuning in at home, ladies and gents. We'll check you soon on our next episode of The Groove Cartel.